Hello everyone, welcome to another lecture of the course Digital Signal Processing. Till now we have been discussing about filter designing. We have considered two classes of filters, that is FIR filters and IIR filters, that is finite impulse response filters and infinite impulse response filters. So the discussion of IIR filters, we had started it by comparing the properties of FIR and IIR filters. So let's revisit those things. So we had said that the FIR filter has a transfer function as h of z is equal to summation k running from 0 to m bk z to the power minus k, whereas IIR filter transfer function is given as h of z is equal to summation k running from 0 to m bk z to the power minus k divided by summation k running from 0 to n ak z to the power minus k. And we know that this FIR filter is of finite duration, whereas these IIR filters' impulse response is of infinite duration. Moreover, these FIR filters are causal or can be made causal by introduction of some certain amount of delay. So the finite amount of delay's introduction can be used in order to make a non-causal filter to a causal filter, but this is not the case for the IIR filter. Rather, the causality depends on the transfer function and the values of m and n. Moreover, these FIR filters are always stable, but the stability of IIR filters is not guaranteed. We have linear phase characteristics in the case of FIR filters, which cannot be obtained for IIR filters. But we have also said that if we are given a same set of specifications, then in that case, those specifications can be achieved at a very low order in case of IIR filter. Moreover, the IIR filters are precise as compared to FIR filter. And we have also seen from the design process that the FIR filters do not require any analog background, whereas the designing of IIR filter is completely dependent on the analog background. So now let us look at these things. So let us consider a same set of specifications for the design of FIR and IIR filter. So for that, let us consider an example in which this FP, that is passband edge, is given as 3 kHz. The stopband edge is given as 5 kHz. This passband attenuation is given as minus 0.0546 dB. This AS, that is stopband attenuation, is given as minus 30 dB. So now we have been given the specifications in the analog domain. So now in order to convert it into the digital or discrete time domain, what we need to have is a sampling frequency. So let us consider the sampling frequency, that is if f sample as 20 kHz. And in order to design a digital filter, we first need to convert these analog frequencies into the digital frequencies. So that can be achieved using the formula. We have omega p is equal to 2 pi fp by f sample, which is equal to 2 pi into 3 into 10 to the power 3 divided by 20 into 10 to the power 3, which is equal to 0.3 pi. And the stopband edge in the digital domain can be calculated as 2 pi fs upon f sample, which is equal to 2 pi into 5 into 10 to the power 3 divided by 20 into 10 to the power 3, which is equal to 0.5 pi. So let us now start designing an FIR filter. So let us consider the first case, that is FIR filter. So we have the condition as omega p is equal to 0.3 pi. This omega s is equal to 0.5 pi. So if we observe it carefully, the scenario is something like this. So we have a pass band till 0.3 pi, and then we have stop band after 0.5 pi. So this frequency here is basically omega p, and the frequency here is omega s. So this resembles a low pass filter, therefore we need to design a low pass FIR filter with this given specifications. If we look at the values of passband and stopband edges, then these specifications match with the specifications for a Hanning window. So what we are going to consider is designing using Hanning window. And it is given as W of n is equal to 0.5 plus 0.5 cos of 4 pi n upon m, where this n is varying from minus m by 2 to m by 2. Now we see that this is a non-causal thing, so we need to introduce a certain amount of delay. So what we do is we consider W of n minus m by 2, which is equal to 0.5 minus 0.5 cos of 4 pi n by m, and this is valid for 0 to m. And it is equal to 0 otherwise. So this Hanning window we are going to consider, and now in order to have the Hanning window we require two things, the order and the cutoff frequency. So the order can be obtained using the transition width of this Hanning window, which is given as, so the transition width, that is delta omega for the Hanning window, is given as 8 pi upon m, which is equal to omega s minus omega p, which is equal to 0.5 pi minus 0.3 pi. Therefore we have 8 pi by m is equal to 0.2 pi, which implies that m is equal to 40. So the order of the filter, we obtain it as 40. And now as we need to design a low pass filter, the first thing that we need to do is we need to design an ideal low pass filter. And moreover, we need to consider the causality, that is we need to shift the ideal low pass filter by a factor of m by 2. So what we have is this ideal filter, that is H ideal of n, in case of causal filter, is given as sine of omega c into n minus m by 2 divided by n minus m by 2 into pi. So this is valid for n not equal to m by 2, and it is equal to omega c by pi for n is equal to m by 2. And this cutoff frequency omega c can be calculated as the average of passband edge, that is omega p plus omega s by 2, which is equal to 0.5 pi plus 0.3 pi by 2, which is equal to 0.4 pi. So therefore the ideal filter equation can be calculated as, we have H ideal of n is equal to sine of omega c, that is 0.4 pi inside the bracket n minus m by 2, we have m as 40, so it is n minus 20, divided by n minus 20 into pi, and this is valid for n not equal to 20, and it is equal to omega c by pi, that is 0.4 for n equal to 20. So this is the ideal low pass filter, and now in order to have the final filter, that is h of n, so it is given as h ideal of n multiplied by w of n minus m by 2. So this w of n minus m by 2 is the Hanning window, and this is the final expression for the low pass filter for an FIR low pass filter of order n equal to 40 and cutoff frequency as 0.4 pi. So now this was the case for the FIR filter. So now let us consider the case of the IIR filter. So the second case is IIR filter, and we have omega p is equal to 0.3 pi, omega s is equal to 0.5 pi. So now what we have is the first step as pre-warping, or rather the initial step as pre-warping, so it is given as omega p is equal to tan of small omega p by 2, which comes out to be 0.5095. omega s can be calculated as tan of omega s by 2, which comes out to be 1. Then what we need to do is find the order, that is n is equal to log to the base 10, 10 to the power mod of as by 10 minus 1 divided by 10 to the power mod of ap by 10 minus 1 whole divided by 2 times log to the base 10 omega s by omega p, and this comes out to be 8.361, and when we seal it, it is equal to 9. Therefore the order n for the IR filter is 9. Now once we have the order, we can find h of s, which is equal to 1 upon product of k running from 0 to n minus 1 s minus sk, where this sk is given as e to the power j pi by 2 inside the bracket 2k plus n plus 1 upon n, so using this formula, that is considering this n as 9 and this k varying from 0 to 8, we can find this h of s, which is the expression for the normalized low pass filter. Then we need to find the cutoff frequency for the low pass filter as omega s upon 10 to the power mod of as by 10 minus 1 to the power 1 by 2n, and then we need to substitute this s as s by omega c in this transfer function, and then what we obtain is the required low pass filter, required analog low pass filter, and at the end we need to use bilinear transform in which this s is to be substituted as 1 minus z inverse upon 1 plus z inverse, and when we do all these things, what we are left with is this transfer function. So what we observe is the numerator polynomial is of degree n, also the denominator polynomial is of degree n, so basically this is a low pass filter of order n is equal to 9, and we know that this is a digital IIR low pass filter. So if we observe the two design processes and the parameters which we have obtained, we can make the following observations. So the first thing that we can notice is the order. So the order for the FIR filter, that is M, was obtained as 40, whereas the order, that is N, for the IR filter was obtained as 9. So if we observe these two things, we can very well say that the same set of specifications can be achieved at a significantly lower order in the case of IR filter. Another thing that we can notice is this FIR filter is all zero filter. Whereas this IR filter has both poles and zeros. So both poles and zeros are present. We had already seen that these poles and zeros can be used to shoot up or attenuate certain frequencies. For example, the zeros are responsible for attenuation of frequencies. So they attenuate the frequencies at which the zeros are oriented, whereas the poles pass the frequencies or shoot up the frequencies at which they are located. So if we consider this FIR filter, the passband and the stopband is decided on the basis of the positioning of zeros, whereas the passband and stopband is decided by position of both the poles as well as zeros. So what we can see is, due to presence of both poles and zeros, we can achieve a better precision in case of IR filter. So in this lecture, what we have done is we have reconsidered the comparison for the FIR and IR filter with which we had began the discussion for the IR filters. Then we considered a set of example or set of specifications, and using that specifications we have designed both FIR and IR filter, and we made certain observations. So the first observation that we had was in terms of order, and we said that the order for the IR filter was significantly lower as compared to that of FIR filter. And we had also made another observation that this FIR filter is an all zero filter, that is the passband and stopband is decided on the basis of positioning of zeros, and this IR filter has both poles and zeros, therefore the passband and stopband can be designed on the basis of the position of both poles as well as zeros. So we can achieve a better precision in case of IR filters. So let's stop here. Thank you.